Welcome to the Environmental Learning Center. My name is Deb, and thank you for joining me today. Did you know we have insect friends that live here at the ELC? I saw several bumblebees when I arrived today. What have you seen that is interesting in nature recently? Wetlands are nurseries for our wildlife neighbors. What makes a wetland? It's all about the water. Wetlands are places where special plants and animals live because there's a lot of water. Today we are going to explore the home of the dragonfly and damselfly, fierce predators that undergo an amazing transformation. Come on, let's go exploring!
Have you seen the home of a dragonfly or damselfly? We're going on a home tour. Dragonflies and damselflies are invertebrates, which means they don't have a backbone like you and I do. Do you know who else has a backbone? The mallards, frogs, and raccoons we talked about in other episodes. Instead of a backbone, dragonflies and damselflies have an exoskeleton, a hard outer layer they shed as they grow. Animals with a backbone, vertebrates, are hard on the inside and squishy on the outside. Most animals without a backbone are squishy on the inside and hard on the outside. Dragonflies and damselflies are flying insects in the order Odonata, so many people call dragonflies and damselflies odonates. Did you know insects have the greatest number of species and the highest number of individuals on Earth? In just North America, there are nearly 500 species of odonates. Adult dragonflies and damselflies are very colorful like butterflies and come in all sorts of colors and patterns, from green, blue, yellow, and red. Instead of having two eyeballs like mammals and birds, odonates have compound eyes, which is like having lots of small lenses that sense light and movement in all directions. Their brain puts together all the information like ours does. Have you ever wanted to be something completely different than a human? Like a dragon, lion, eagle, or dinosaur? Both dragonflies and damselflies have a transformational life cycle. A baby odonate is so different than an adult odonate, it's like transforming into something completely different. A wetland pond is the nursery for odonates. A female dips the end of her abdomen, which looks like a tail, near the water or into the water and lays her eggs. In a few days, the eggs hatch into nymphs. Nymphs eat and grow, shedding their exoskeleton along the way. When they're ready, they crawl out of the water on a plant, log, or rock. The exoskeleton splits open on the back, and the adult comes out. For baby odonates, the water is also their kitchen. They eat mosquito larvae and small fish. They also eat tadpoles, including Pacific chorus frog tadpoles that we talk about in another episode. They have an extendable lower lip that shoots out into the water to catch their prey. Watch some amazing slow motion videos of this online. For adults, the air is their kitchen. They fly around above water and open areas, hunting mosquitoes and other insects in the air, including yellow jackets. The living room for odonates is places to perch like plants, where they rest in between flying. Where have you seen a dragonfly or damselfly before? The best place to look for odonates in Oregon is around slow-moving water from spring to fall. Look for them flying around, hunting insects and patrolling their territory. Sometimes they hunt away from water in open areas. I watched a couple of dragonflies hunting above my neighbor's driveway in early June. If you watch a dragonfly in the air, notice how fast they fly. Some can fly 35 miles per hour. That's over twice as fast as a bicycle commuter. In summer, look for the empty exoskeletons of nymphs attached to vegetation just above the waterline along ponds or slow-moving water. Some dragonflies migrate, but scientists don't know much about it yet. Imagine how tiny a dragonfly GPS unit would need to be. Sometimes other things look like dragonflies. Have you seen something human-made that looks like something from nature? For a challenging hobby, take up odonate photography. It's hard enough getting focused photos of them perching and even harder when flying. To wrap it all up,
odonates, dragonflies and damselflies, are fierce predators that undergo an amazing transformation. When you visit the ELC or another wetland pond from spring to fall, peek at the plants along the water and look for empty nymph exoskeletons. Watch the adults flying around hunting for insects and feel free to thank them for eating mosquitoes and yellow jackets. Start a nature journal and keep track of your observations. Thank you for joining me today and have a fun time exploring nature.